Motorized Precision and Sean, and he's got some stuff to show you. Check this out.
So this is the traditional way that we've done it for years. We jog around with the Xbox or the PlayStation controller, keyframes on a timeline, and run the move. Nice, smooth, continuous, smart focus, dolly zooms in there, everything in one package. But what we're gonna show is what just came out, and you can download it on the App Store, MP space AR, check it out. So we're gonna come over here, we're gonna make a new move for you guys right now. I'm gonna call it a new move. We're gonna do a recorded move. We're gonna calibrate our scene. We're gonna calibrate our robot using this really cool little QR here. And now we're gonna start designing moves. So I'm just gonna come in here and hit record on my iPad. And anything I do, it will record all the way up top here, down here, any little banking movements I wanna do like that and that. And we're gonna land right there on the end. Right away, we can see what this is gonna do. So it's really like the ultimate previs tool on any location. What is my robot gonna do? Where is it gonna do it? Is it gonna hit the ceiling as we're in a really small space? Can I fit this robot in here? Is it gonna hit my wall? What does the light look like? You know, like all those sort of things. Now I wanna send it for client approval. I'm gonna send out a shot of exactly what we did as a rough, you know, I'm a director in my living room and I'm trying to convey a message of what we're gonna do. Let's do that. But I actually need to show them with the object or the client's object. So let's put the client's object in there. Our client in this case is the Mandalorian. So we're just gonna put in a little model here. And now we can start making previs around an AR object right in my living room if I wanted to. And we have all of the full models of everything that we offer, Mia, Kira, Vigo, track systems in this app. So when you download it, you can previs and put it right in your living room and see if it's gonna fit or design any move. But since we're actually doing a little product shot of our logo, so let's add a target. I'm gonna switch over to target mode. We're going to grab a little target here and put it on there. So now we have a target keyframe in our shot. All we gotta do is click send to MP Studio and now it's there. You can see right on our timeline, the new move is there. That's our title of the move. And everything that we did with the iPad is showing up right there in MP Studio. If you stay watching this shot, I'm gonna show you that the iPad is actually live moving inside of MP Studio with the camera. It might be a little bit laggy right now because we're at the show with a crazy amount of Wi-Fi, but it's still all there. So we did 13 and a half-ish second move, and we're playing it back right away with every little bit of shake and bump and everything that the director wanted in there. So it's a repeatable handheld shot, a motion control, accurately repeatable handheld shot. So let's take a look at that right now. I'm gonna go to my starting position and we're gonna run our move. Really fast rolls there. You can hear the robot going. So that's cool if you want that handheld feel and you want to have an action move or you have, maybe you're fighting yourself in a scene and you need to have all the chaos, but repeatable so you can switch yourself in and out or change the background. You can finally do that in a handheld style shot. So what if you just wanted a traditional bottle shot? You're actually trying to do a table chop shot. So we're just gonna click this little C and convert that entire path to keyframes. You saw at the beginning how we do one keyframe at a time using the Xbox or jogging the controller. Now we've created 39 keyframes in about 13 and a half seconds. It took me 13 seconds to create the move, 1 second to convert it, and now we have 39 keyframes worth of editable positions. So I'm just gonna lasso those keyframes and we're gonna make them all target. Let's get the rest of these, make these target. So now we'll have, after I've target locked, we're gonna have a more traditional motion control tabletop shot. So it's gonna look at our target that we set. It's gonna be level, it's gonna be smooth, it's gonna be, have the energy of that handheld feel to it still, but be more traditionally locked, of course still smart focus and smoother right away. And then of course we can go in and edit anything we want, but this is like a 14 second head, you know, it's all it takes to get a huge head start on creating a motion control path. Besides the previs aspect of the app.
So, I know every single time we use this, it's always a different environment, but
yes.
From the typical workload day of, yes. of a normal robot, how many more shots per day can you get by cutting down this time?
Absolutely. So the question is how many shots we can do in a day now that we've added the app. So traditionally, you saw we already are very quick. Like MP Studio is the world's most simple intuitive motion control software for a reason. We were doing about 30 to 40 shots in a day. You can really do that. Now that we can make a new shot in exactly the real time aspect of it, it's endless. You can do hundreds of shots if you want in a day by just making them. Like the app stores every single one of those shots and your timeline can have just a ginormous amount of shots.
Is there a share collaborative ability?
There
so,
is.
Like you have so-and-so in San Francisco that has a robot and someone else and you want to do the same shots.
Yep. So you can send this MPAR move from the app. So the export screen had a few other things to it. So you can send straight live to MP Studio, which is what we were doing here, instantly to MP Studio. Or I can share my moves out and it will share every single move that you've taken. The entire list of moves, which I'll show you here. So if I go back one, all of these moves that we've done in the last 2 days, you can send all of those to another robot and they can run any one of them. All of them will show up in MP Studio as soon as you hit import.
And it doesn't really matter so much about the
location.
Placement
because nope, you can just replace it. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So you can replace it on their robot. They calibrate the app, kind of bring it in. Yeah.
And is this all just included with the robot?
This is in the App Store. You can literally just buy this. Like Scott, you have an iPhone. I'll show you this. You like he'll scan this on here and he'll show you where it goes. So like he's gonna scan this QR code and then we can show you on the. On the app where it goes.
First time using the phone,
right? So then we're just gonna click this. And then that's where you can get it. That's what it costs. You can download it, anybody can use it. And it does everything that you saw here, plus probably more.
$50 is nothing.
It's the cheapest product that we offer.
Right?
Yeah.
Except for the shirts.
The shirts are free, yeah.
That's kind of amazing.
We think it's gonna change the way that motion control is communicated,
yeah.
Right? It's a communication tool and the way in which it's approached for workflow.
Everybody in the robot world is trying to figure out how do we take human and convert it to robot.
Because we've done that here.
That is as close as I've ever seen to the way we think as humans.
How often are we saying, I'm the director, I just want this,
right.
I'm sending you an iPhone clip, I'll airdrop it to you, do that for me. We've now given them the ability to actually do it and play it back instantly with exactly what they wanted.
Well, I just recently posted on Facebook just a question about people who use motion control and or don't.
Exactly.
And why? And the number one reason that people didn't want to use it is the flexibility to pivot to how to change quickly. That's
And I posted a comment on there, come on by the booth, check it out. And now we've solved that issue for most people. We want to get the message out there that we've solved it. And our job at Motorized Precision has always been to think ahead and be the leader in what's next and how things are done. Obviously, MP Studio was a big part of that. And now MPAR is the next part of that.
Yeah.
Thanks for checking us out. I really think that where we're going in the future and the next things that we're working on will be really exciting. So keep following us and check us out online or on Instagram at Motorized Precision. And thanks so much.